गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द पोएम ऑन रिसीट ऑफ माई मदर्स पिक्चर रिटन बाय विलियम कूपर. सो इन द फिफ्थ स्टैंजा पोएट वॉज आस्किंग फॉर द मेमोरीज विच वॉज देयर इन हिज माइंड. मे बी पीपल विल नॉट नोटिस मच, बट इन हेवन His mother will remember all these things. So he is planning for something to write, something for his mother. So shall we start with the sixth stanza? It is not scorn in the heaven rough, little notice here. Good time his flight reversed. Restore the hours when playing with thy vultures, tissues, flowers, the violet, the pink, the jasmine. I pricked them into paper with a pin, and thou was happier than myself the while. So in this stanza, in the sixth stanza of the poem, here also he is talking about the childhood memories, childhood naughty things and all. He is saying that you used to give me mother sweets when I used to go out. You used to spray rose water on me. And now he is saying that if time can reverse, I wish that if time can reverse, then I will restore my time. I want to restore my old childhood memories. Then he is remembering that I play with dress dry flowers. I will play dress dry flowers that are pink, violet and jasmine. When I was a little child, then also I used to play with these type of flowers, and you seemed very happy than me. You seems to happy more than me. I pricked them into paper with a pin, and thou was happier than myself. At that time, you seemed to happier than me. Would softly speak and stroke my head and smile. Could those few pleasant hours again appear? So he is wishing that would that time will come again. He is wishing, but he is saying, but I cannot believe this, but it is not at all possible, because we cannot get our memories back, our time back. But no, I don't want to bring it back. But suddenly in the next moment he is saying that, but no, I don't want to bring it back. Why? I would not trust my heart. Might one wish bring back? Would I wish thee them here? I would not trust my heart, but it is not possible. The dear delight seems so to be desired. Perhaps I might, but no. What here we call our life is such, so little to be loved, and thou so much, that I should ill require thee to constrain thy unbound spirit into bounds again. So he is saying that, mother, I don't want to bring it back. I am already stuck in this materialistic world. This world is not fit for you, mother. I am already stuck in this world. She is liberal. Now you are free. You are liberal. Your spirit is free. You can feel, you can get anything, whatever you want, because you are in heaven. I should not call you back for myself. Poet thinks that somewhere maybe I have become selfish, but yes, I don't want to you come back for myself. She is like a free bird. Now you are a free bird. You can fly anywhere you want. Next stanza. Thou as a gallant bark from Albanian coast. You are like a gallant bark from Albanian coast. The storm all were all weathered and ocean crossed, where you are like a albino coast crossed the ocean. You are a bird that crossed the albino ocean and reaches its island, no matter how trouble they get. Means no matter how storms they get, how barriers they get in their journey, but they reaches at albino coast. So your spirit is like also there, and that gallant bark shoots into port at some well heaven eyes, where spices breathe, and they reach where spices breathe. In that garden there are so much spices, that is like heaven. They don't matter for storms, but they reaches at spices breathe, that is heaven. Heaven is here personified as a spice garden, full of bounty, full of things, full of beautiful scenario, full of fragrance. There sits quiet scent on the floods that show her beauteous form reflected clear below. Your spirit will sit there, and my mother is sitting there, her beauteous reflection is coming there. I am imagining that your reflection is coming in that. There sits quiet scent on floods that show her beauteous form reflected clear below. In that clear water, your reflection is there, and you looks very beautiful in that reflection. While airs impregnant with incense play around her fanning light, her streamy grey, so thou with sails how swift. Here you sails with how swift has thou reached the shore, and your spirit reaches there where tempest never beat, where tempest never comes, nor billows roar. And thy love's consort on the dancing tide of life, long silent, long since has anchored at thy side. But me, scarce hoping to attain that rest, always from port withheld, always distressed, me holding wind drive, devious tempest tossed, sails ripped, seams on opening wide, and compass lost, and day by day some current throwing force sets me more distant from a propos course. So in these lines he is saying that my mother is like a bird who is crossing the albino coast, and in that her spirit is looking very beautiful and sparky. So this is enough for today. Next stanza we will deal in the coming days. Okay, thank you my dear friends.